Hi, hope everyone's good. I totally lost track of time this morning. I've been running around panicking trying to find my glasses, and then they're on my head, so I think it's gonna be one of those days. Oh, my phone charger's in the shot. Right, we're nearly there with our Otis, so we're gonna be stitching him together today. Cat hair there. So, we've got our front and back pieces, which we will need. And we also need our four hands that we haven't used yet. And we need our brown thread, which was in your kit. And we need our needle and our pins as well. And then shortly we're going to use our stuffing, which is in your kit, and you also want some scissors, and you might want something to stuff your animal with. So I'm going to use a pen, but you can also use a pencil if you use like the non drawing end, just so it doesn't make any marks, which just makes it a bit easier when you're stuffing the thinner areas. So the first thing I'm going to do to get him ready to sew together is just place the front onto the back and make sure the edges are lined up. So I'm going to make sure the piece is the right way round to line up the edges. So this way. I've got a bit more of a relaxing playlist on today, so hopefully we won't have any chaotic dance music again. So, that's there. And then I'm just going to put the hands, pop each one between each of the ends of the arms and legs, sandwich them between in the front and the back. So I've got the thumbs all facing inwards. And I'm going to pop them about half a centimetre in, just so that they'll be secure when you stitch them. So you do that for all four. Like that. And now I'm going to get my pins. And I'm just going to secure them in place so that they'll stay when I'm stitching through them. So I'm just going to pop the pin. Oh, that one's a bit blunt. So I'm just going to pin through all the layers through to the back, and that's just secured the hand in place so that when we stitch it, it's just going to stay nicely how you want it to be. So again, I'm going to pop it in about half a centimetre from the edge between the front and the back. Pin through all the layers so it's nice and secure like that. Just going to do that with the other two down here. Really hoping that I'm going to be able to get through this whole live today without my camera pausing. It keeps doing it for some reason or other. Still getting the hang of it. I'm just going to get another pin because I've got a dodgy one. So again, I'm just putting it about half a centimetre inside, sandwiched between your front and your back piece, and secure with a pin, putting through all the layers so it's nice and secure. So they're all pinned in place now, ready to go. I'll just show you quickly. I've been putting these strings in the kits. I think I started doing it a week or so ago with orders. So these are new, that you can get them in the kits, so if you want to hang your animal. We're not going to bother with this today. This is going to go in at the end tomorrow when he's all stitched up. So don't worry about that for today. You don't need it. Just thought I'd go through that in case you're wondering. So we're ready to stitch it now. So on your body template, I've done this with all the kits. It's marked where to start your blanket stitch. So you don't have to use this. It's just, I suppose it's just kind of, I can't get my words out today. I've got such bad brain fog. It's just probably an easier place for you to start, so it's not too fiddly, and it doesn't matter which direction you go in. So I'm just going to pull off a strand of thread again, like I have been doing. So if you see that, again, they naturally separate, and I'm just going to gently pull one off. And then I'm going to start the thread by tying a few knots again so that it doesn't pull through. Thread my needle. At the end, I haven't tied the knot in. Like so. Put that to the side. So, like I say, this is just a guide. You don't have to use this. It's just a nice, easy place to start where it won't be too fiddly for you. So, what we're going to do for our blanket stitch is, we're going to make a starting stitch and we're going to come up between the two layers you want to stitch together, and we're going to come up from the bottom of the top layer, like so. And just check that you can see that. So we're coming up from that top layer from the inside, and where you bring your needle up will determine how long the stitch is. So if you want it to be a bit smaller, you might come up bit closer to the edge. So I'm going to bring that up. Little stuffing stuck in it. So that's now been secured with your knot that you've tied. And this top layer here, you're not going to put that into the stitching. That's going to stay loose like this. So just don't put your needle through that as you're doing it. Just leave that, which makes that nice effect of fur. So I've brought my needle up, and then making sure your edges are lined up. So there's a bit there that's not actually lined up, so I'm just going to very carefully trim that so that they're the same. It'll just make it neater when you sew it together if the edges are matching up. So that's what you want to do. So I've brought my needle up from the inside. And I'm going to just go bring the thread over the layers I want to stitch together, so the front and the back. And then I'm going to take, let me check so you can see it. I'm going to take the needle back through into the same point. Let me do this a bit better. Can you see that there? I'm going to take the needle through, over and through, into the same point where I started. So if I pull it a bit tighter, I can show you what I've done. So don't pull it all the way, but if you see, it's made kind of a loop going over the two layers that you want to sew together. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the needle through the loop now from the front to the back to kind of catch it. So like that. And then just pull it tight, and that's made your starting stitch. And then to start the blanket stitch properly, we're going to just keep going through the back, through both layers you want to stitch together, like so. And again, don't pull it all the way, so it makes kind of this little loop. And then pull the needle through from the front to the back to catch it, like that. So then I'm going to pull that tight. And it's then just repeating that all the way around. So again, taking the needle from the back to the front through the layers you want stitched together. And again, where you bring your needle up, that will determine the length of the stitch. So if you did it closer to the edge, it would be a shorter stitch. So I'm going to take it through the two layers I want to sew together till there's a little loop. I'm not going to pull it tight yet. And then I'm going to take the needle through to catch it and pull it tight, like that. Through from the back, through both layers. Wait till there's a little loop and then take your needle through, like so. So I'm just going to keep doing that now. And that's how you do your blanket stitch. Through both layers from the back. Till there's a little loop. And then take the needle through from the front to back to catch it, like that. Like so. So I'm just going to keep going all the way down till I get to the hand, and then I can show you how we're going to stitch through that as well to secure it in place. So I'm just keeping doing my blanket stitch through from the back, through both layers you're stitching. Don't pull it tight, so you've got a little loop, and then take the needle through from front to back to catch it and pull it like that. And again, just make sure both your edges of the felt you're stitching together are lined up so it's nice and neat. So again, I'm just going to trim this little edge here because it's not quite lining up, just to make it nice and neat. Careful not to cut through my thread. Okay, so I'm nearly at the first hand, so I'm going to show you how we're going to secure that in place. So I've just done my last blanket stitch, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the needle and come through from the back. Again, at the where I put the needle will determine the length of my stitch. So I'm going to take the needle through. Bring it through the length of the stitch I want to be. And then I'm going to take it down and through at the next point that I want the next stitch to be. I'm going to take the pin out to try and show you a bit better. It's tricky because it doesn't really show up on the brown. So I'm just trying to make sure you can see it. So I've brought the needle up at the point I want the stitch to be. I'm going to take it back down and come through the back at the point I want the next stitch to be, which just makes a little vertical stitch. And then again, I'm gonna go up from the back and put my needle through the layers of felt at, again, at the point I want my next stitch to be. So we're going up and through the felt, and then up and back through, which just makes these little vertical stitches, and all three layers of felt are secured in there then. So up and through, and up and through. So now that, hand's stitched in, I'm going to go back to doing the blanket stitch again. So I'm going to go over the layers I want to stitch together again and through the same point where the thread is. Wait till there's a loop, so don't pull it tight, and take the needle back through again to blanket stitch. Let me know if there's any of these techniques that I haven't explained very well, and I'll make another thing and put it on my grid. There's another video on YouTube as well covering how to do this if you're not quite clear. So I'm just going to keep doing my blanket stitch, making sure that this top orange layer isn't attached in, because that's going to be staying loose. So I'm just keeping blanket stitching. I'm coming towards the end of my thread now, so in a minute I will show you how to finish it and restart with another piece of thread. Okay, that's getting quite short now, so I'm going to finish the thread off. Just re-threading my needle. So there's lots of different ways you can finish your thread for this. This is the way I prefer to do it, but there are other ways you can do it too. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go over a few times the same stitch I've just done to secure the thread a bit. So I'm just going over the same stitch. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the needle through the middle of the two layers, so I haven't gone through any felt, it's just going between the middle, just kind of threading the sandwiching the thread through the two layers, and then I'm just going to take the needle up through the front, so that's then made a tail of thread on the inside. So it's, I've done my stitches there, and then the thread has gone up through here and through the front, which has just made a tail for it. And then I'm just going to tie it in a knot. And then I'm just going to snip the thread. And that's how I finish it. If you'd prefer to, you can just go over the stitch a few times like I did and then just tie a knot without threading it through. I just find that that's a bit more secure as it gives a bit of a tail of thread on the inside so it doesn't unravel so easily if it was to come undone. I'm just going to move that pin because it's... I'm just going to trim this as it's not quite lining up and pin the foot back in. So I'm ready to start with a new piece of thread. So again, I'm going to get my thread that came in my kit and pull off one strand again. So if you just gently pull it away, it should be fine and not tangle. Sorry, I keep hitting my tripod with my hand, making it jiggle. So I'm just tying a few knots to secure the end of the thread. Again, so when I bring the thread through, it will secure. Thread the other end with my needle, like so. So I'm just going to trim that little bit again. You might get this that the pieces are a slightly different size just as you're hand cutting them, so don't worry if you do need to trim the edges so that they line up. You just want them to line up nicely so that it's nice and neat. So I'm just going to take that pin out and hold it so that I can just show you how to do it better. So again, I'm going to make my starting stitch for blanket stitch. So I'm going to bring the thread through from the underneath of the top layer again, and I'm going to bring the needle up. Oh, I'm starting in the wrong place, it's over here. I did say I've got brain fog today, didn't I? I don't know what it is, I think I'm just tired this week. So again, I'm going to bring the needle up from the underside of the top layer, this layer here. I'm going to bring it up at the point I want the stitch to be. So that will determine the length of my stitch. And I'm going to bring it through, and then it's been secured with that knot I've tied again. So that's on the inside between the two layers. And I'm going to make my starting stitch by bringing the thread over and through the back. So it's over both layers I'm stitching together, and bringing the needle up at the same point where I just did that starting stitch. And I'm not going to pull it tight, so it's going to make a little loop. And then I'm going to thread the needle from the front to the back through the loop to catch it like this. So that's what it will look like. So that's my starting stitch again. And then I'm just going to keep blanket stitching. So through from the back, through both layers I want to stitch together, bringing the needle up at the point that I want the length of the stitch to be, and not pulling it tight so that it's making, not pulling it tight so that it's made a little loop, and taking the thread through then from the front to the back to catch the loop and pulling it tight. So this is what it will look like before you pull it tight. Is that easier to see? So pull that tight and just continuing that blanket stitch again. So bringing the needle through from the back through both layers I'm stitching together at the point I want the stitch to be, creating that little loop, and then taking the thread through from the front to back to catch it in place like that. Through from the back, making the loop and taking it through like so. And keep going. God, I haven't lined this up for a while. Just trim that. And put the hand back in so that fell out when I took the pin out. I'm going to check the time. I'm trying to keep these under an hour. Yeah, that's fine. So again, I'm just going to make these little vertical stitches now to secure the hand in place. So we're going to come through from the back at the point we want our stitch length to be, through the layers we're stitching together, so through the back and the hand and the front, coming through at the point where we want the stitch to be, and then up and through at the next point that we want the stitch to be, like that. So it's just making these little vertical stitches up through the point we want the stitch to be, up through at the point we want the stitch to be. Up through at the point we want the stitch to be, up through at the point we want the stitch to be, up through at the point we want the stitch to be, up through. So that's secured the next hand in place. So it's just made these little vertical stitches. And then again, we're going to start a blanket stitch again. So we're doing the starter stitch by coming through from the underneath of the top layer at the point you want the stitch to be again. And then when we get our loop, we're going to again take the needle through from the front and back before we pull it tight. And just keep going with that again. So now we've done our starting stitch for our blanket stitch. We're again going through from the back of the layers we want to stitch together, up at the point we want our stitch to be, not pulling tight, so we've got this little loop, and then pulling the thread through from front to back to catch it like that. And pulling tight, and that's just blanket stitch again. Just keep going round. A little bit again that's not quite lining up, so I'm just going to trim it, making sure I don't get the thread in. So I'm just trimming it so that the edges line up nicely, and that will just mean when it is stitched the edge will be nice and neat. So again, just blanket stitching round. And in a minute, we're going to start putting some of our stuffing in as well, which I will show you how to do. the blanket stitching round. I'm going to wait till this thread is finished and then I will show you how to start stuffing as we go. So in this blanket stitching, keeping going, blanket stitching round. So again, as you go, just make sure your edges are nicely lined up and flat, just to make the edge nice and neat. So I'm coming to the end of my thread again now, so I'm just going to finish it off. So I'm just going to do the same I did before, where I just go over the same stitch a few times to secure the thread. And then I'm just going to thread the needle through between the two layers to make a little tail of thread on the inside and then bring it back through. So then on the inside there will be that bit of thread that's kind of going through, so that if my thread does unravel, that little tail will mean that it will stay in place and won't unravel all our stitching. So now that I've got that end of thread, I'm just going to tie a knot and then trim it off. So, and just trim the end. So, I've stitched a fair bit of this now. So, it's now starting to make a bit of a pocket with the two layers where they've been stitched together. So, now I can start putting some stuffing in and it will stay in place. It just makes it easier if you stuff as you go, so you haven't got a challenge to get it into these smaller areas, so it's easier to just do it as you go a bit. So we've got our stuffing that came in our kit, and what we want to do is we just want to use little bits at a time, and if you gently pull it apart it will separate the fibres of the stuffing a bit, just so that stop it going lumpy. It will be nice and soft and squishy when you put it in then. So I'm just going to break off little bits and I'm going to put it between the two layers in this kind of pocket that we've made with our stitching. And then you might want something to push it in to the thinner area. So I'm just going to use the end of a pen. And I'm not going to do it too hard, as that will, it might stretch the felt and kind of make it go a bit out of shape. I'm just using the pen to gently push the stuffing into the areas I've already stitched up. So again, I'm just breaking off small pieces to separate it a bit so that it's nice and soft when it goes in and doesn't go lumpy, and just gently pushing it in, using my pen to help for these thinner areas. Again, I don't want to push too hard as it might stretch the felt and distort it a bit. So that's that leg done. Just break off small pieces and gently push them into your animal. And this just makes it easier for you if you do it as you go, so you haven't got fiddly getting into difficult corners with not much room to work with. So you just get into it nice and easily if you've still got this big opening here. So that's my two legs stuffed. Breaking the stuffing up gently so it's nice and soft. And gently pushing it in. Like that. So I've kind of stuffed so far the area that we've already stitched up. So now I'm just going to keep going, start my thread again, and kind of just stuff as I go until I'm finished. So that's ready. So just going to get my thread again and pull off one strand gently, and it just kind of gently pull it away so it doesn't tangle. And again, just tied a few knots in the end to stop the thread pulling through when I start. And then I'm just threading the needle at the other end. And again, I'm just going to keep blanket stitching. So I'm going to come up from the underside of my top layer. And then that's now been secured on the inside with the knot. And there's no need to worry what it looks like inside, because this will obviously be covered and hidden away when we finish stitching. So I've got my thread there, and I'm just going to go over both the layers I'm stitching together, leaving this orange one free. Bring the needle over and through that same point. And then I'm not going to pull it tight, so it's got this loop, and take the needle back through from the front to the back to catch it, like so. That's the starter stitch again, and then I'm just going to keep blanket stitching by coming up at the point I want my stitch to start, not pulling tight, and then taking the needle through, like so. So just keep doing that now. and just making sure I don't get this orange layer in, as that's going to be left nice and free when it's finished. So I'm just going to hold that all the way. Oh, what's happened there? I've picked up some stray thread. So we're nearly at the next hand, and I'll show you how to stitch through that again. Take the pin out just so that I can show you a bit better. So I'm just keeping blanket stitching till I get to my hand. Like so. So now I'm ready to stitch. Oh, I've caught the stitching a bit there. There we go. It's alright. So now we're ready to stitch through our hand again. So again, I'm just going to take the needle through at the point we want the stitch to start, like so, through all our layers. And then we're just making these vertical stitches again. So we're going up through all the layers and take the needle through at the point you want your stitch to start. Up and through all the layers at the point you want the next stitch to start. Oh. Up and through at the point you want the next stitch to start, just to make these little vertical stitches. And through the point you want the next stitch to start. Up and through at the point you want the next stitch to start. Ooh. So now that we've got through that hand again, we're going to go back to blanket stitching. So we're just going to come from the back through the layers to make our loop again and take the needle through to catch it like we have been all the way around. I keep wobbling that tripod. I have to move it over a bit next time. Check it's still in the camera view. So now that we've stitched this next arm, I'm going to just put some more stuffing in a minute. Again, I'm just stitching through these two brown layers. I'm not stitching this orange in. And that will give our Otis his nice shaggy effect when it's finished. So I've got a little pocket again that's not got any stuffing, so I'm just going to put some more in. So again, I'm just breaking off small pieces and pulling them apart a bit so that it's separated and not doesn't go lumpy when you put it in. And again, I'm just going to use the end of my pen to ease it into these trickier bits, and I'm not going to push too hard, I'm just going to do it gently so that it doesn't stretch your felt. Like so. Pop some more stuffing in there. I'm just going to keep going my blanket stitch again. And if there are any kind of loose fibres of stuffing hanging out, you can just gently push them in as you go, and that will just make the finish nice and neat so it's not trapped in your stitching. So I'm just keeping the edges lined up as I go. I'm coming to the end of my thread again, so I'll just show you how to finish it again. And start with a new piece. So now I'm just going to finish my thread again and start with another piece. So again, I'm just going to go over the same stitch that I've done a few times to secure it a bit. And then I'm going to thread the needle through the two layers just to, on the inside, make a tail thread and then bring it up so that you've got that thread going through on the inside, and then just tie a knot to secure it. Trim the end. So I'm just going to get another bit of thread by pulling off a strand gently, and again start it by just tying a few knots in the end to secure it. Oh, we've nearly been an hour. We're nearly done now. So I'm just going to thread the end that I haven't knotted with my needle again. And bring the needle up through from the underneath of the top layer. Like so. And then again, that thread is now secured with my knots that I've made. Oh, what have I done? Just checking I didn't have any questions or anything. So now I'm just again going to make my starting stitch of my blanket stitch. So I've brought the thread up through, oh, my knot's just come through, pulled it a bit hard. So we bring the needle up through from the underside of our top layer, which will then be secured in place with your knot. And then we're going over the layers that we want to stitch together and back through the same point. Not pulling tight, so it's got this little loop, and then pulling the needle through to catch that. And then through both layers at the point where the stitch to start to create the loop, and then taking the needle back through again to catch it. And that's just the same way we've done all the way around with our blanket stitch. So I'm just holding this bit of orange out the way as I go, as we don't want that included in the stitching. We want that to be free after, so that he's got his nice shaggy effect. Keeping stitching through. Like so. And now we're on the last hand, so we're just going to make these little vertical stitches again that we have been doing. So we're going to take the needle through at the point we want the stitch to start, through all our layers. And then, keep wobbling that. And then again, we're just going to go up through at the point we want the stitch to start. Up. And through at the point on the stitch to start, through all the layers so that the hand is sandwiched between the front and the back. Like so. Which is again just making those little vertical stitches. That's our last hand secured now. So we're just going to go back to doing our blanket stitch again, as we have been. Oh, nearly got the orange then. So I'm just holding it out the way. If you need to, you could use a pin for this to keep it out of the way. Just keeping going with my blanket stitch. So we're nearly now at the point where we started, so we've got this little opening here. So I'm just going to pop the last bit of stuffing in before we finish it. So again, I'm just breaking off small bits of stuffing so that it's nice and loose and doesn't go lumpy when you put it in. So I'm probably going to need my pen for this bit because it's a bit fiddly. I'm just going to gently push it in between the two layers into the areas that aren't stuffed. Again, don't push it too hard so that the felt doesn't stretch or get pulled out of shape. So just putting in that last bit of stuffing. So I've still got quite a lot of stuffing left, so you should have plenty, and you don't need to use it all. You just want it to have a nice squishy feel to it. You don't want it to be too overstuffed, or it might again stretch the felt a bit and make it lose its shape slightly. So I'm just going to gently with my end of my pen just push in those last few bits of stuffing so that it's not poking out when I stitch it. And then I'm just going to keep blanket stitching till I get back to the point where I started at the beginning. Like so. Again, making sure the edges are nicely lined up, keeping it flat, and just stitching through those two body layers with a blanket stitch. So now I'm back at the point where I started, so I'm just going to finish off my stitching again. So I'm just going to go over the same stitch again a few times, like we've been doing. And then again, I'm going to take the thread through the middle of the two front and back layers to create a bit of a tail on the inside, and bring it through further down, and that will just mean if the thread does come undone, there's a little tail on the inside which will kind of stop it unraveling and undo your stitching. So I've got that end of thread, and now I'm just going to tie a knot. You might want to do a couple to make sure it's nice and secure, like that, and trim the edge off. From the end of thread, and that is my Otis done. So if you don't want to hang him, he's good to go, you're finished now. If you do want to hang him, we're going to be doing that tomorrow, so you've got these bits, this nice thread in your kits, and what we're going to be doing is we're going to be attaching the string under his hands so that it looks like he's hanging, which is fun to hang up in your room or where you want to display it. So that's what we're going to do tomorrow. It's a nice short one. I hope that was helpful. If there's anything I haven't covered, or if you want me to explain it again, let me know. You can always pop me a message, or there are more videos on my YouTube channel, and I'll put these up later. Hope you have a good day. Bye.